Thank you very much.
Okay, so now it's the turn of Cristina Abate with the presentation effect of Cinaria cardunculus allelopathic activity on soil with seed bank and the eubacterial communities. Cristina, try to stay okay. In 15 minutes, okay? Thank
okay.
you.
Okay. So, good morning to everybody. And first of all, I would like to thank you for your kind attention and patience, because I know that my talk is just before the coffee break. And then I would like to thank the scientific committee to give me the possibility to present my our work. So the topic is the effect of the allelopathic activity of Cinaria cardunculus, both on soil with seed bank and eubacterial communities. As everybody knows, the allelopathy involves any direct or indirect positive or negative effect by one plant on another one, by releasing chemical compounds that are released in the environment. These chemical compounds are the secondary metabolites, and they are called allelochemicals, and normally belong to acetate and shikimate pathway. They can be grouped into several classes, such as phenolic compounds, terpenoids, and other such as alkaloids. Here, the allelopathy compounds are released into the environment through four different pathways: volatilization, leaching, decomposition of plant residues, and root exudation. Normally, they don't act alone, but they follow multiple cascade events. In this slide are reported the main important plant species that present allelopathic properties. And as you can see, there are both arboreal and herbaceous species, and many seedweeds as well, very common in Mediterranean basin. So we choose Cinaria cardunculus because until now in the literature there are no data about its allelopathy activity. And Cinaria cardunculus is a very complex species, belongs to the Asteraceae family, very common in Mediterranean basin, and it includes three varieties, botanical varieties: the globe artichoke, the cultivated cardon, and the wild cardon, that is the progenitor of the two domesticated products. The globe artichoke, more than 70% of its production is generated from the Mediterranean basin. The rest, you can find the rest in the Americas and in China. Instead of the cultivated cardon and the wild cardon, the main production is around the Mediterranean basin, Spain, Italy, France, and so on. The chemical compounds released by Cinaria cardunculus were identified by HPLC into these several products, compound, and they belong to two different classes. The first one to the sesquiterpene lactones, such as Cinaria triolo, Cinaria picrine, and the other are polyphenols, such as apigenin or luteolin derivatives. So, the objective of our work was to understand if we can use this species, the Cinaria cardunculus, to control the weeds, and also at the same time which kind of effects it can have on the eubacterial community. To do that, two different experimental trials were performed. The first one for the weed control includes two different experiments. The first one to see the seed germination of some Mediterranean weed species. The other one, the second, to understand the allelopathic activity on weed seed bank sites and composition. For the other approach, the molecular analysis of the bacterial community, we use DGG, it is an electrophoretic technique, and at the same time we tested the antagonistic activity of the Cinara cardunculus on some bacteria involved in nitrogen cycle. So, for the first experiment of the for the weed control, 100 grams of globe artichoke, cultivated cardon, and wild cardon were washed, cut, and ground, and then 1 liter of water was added. The samples were incubated at room temperature in the dark for 2 days. After that, the solution was filtered, and two different dilutions were made, 40%, 80%. So in total, we have 6 treatments, plus the control represented only by distilled water. And we have tested this different solution, so the 40% and 80% of wild cardon and cultivated cardon and globe artichoke on these 7 species very common in Mediterranean basin to see the weed germination, the effect of the weed germination. As you can see in this slide, it's reported the average of the 7 weed species. So the average is we obtained a reduction of seed germination of 39%. But the best result, it was obtained with the cultivated cardon at 80% solution, and it was recording a reduction of the seed germination of 64%. Here are reported results of Amaranthus retroflexus, Portulaca oleracea, and Diplotaxis erucoides, that are the species that present the better results in the 7 totally species that we have tested. And you can see that the results vary from 16% until around 19%. And in some cases, like Portulaca oleracea, these results are independent by the concentration of the solution tested. For the second approach, so to understand the allelopathic activity on wheat soil seed bank, two different experiments were performed in two different areas close to Catania. So the first one is very similar for the soil condition and the climatic condition. The first one experiment was performed in the agricultural experimental farm of Catania University, and the other one in Passitti, that is an area very close to the city. And in the first experiment, in the agricultural experimental farm, there was a monoculture of globe artichoke for 3 years, a monoculture of cultivated cardon for 3 years, and a normal, very common biennial rotation faba bean wheat as control for 4 years. In the other location, we have a monoculture of cultivated cardon for 3 years, a wild cardon monoculture for 3 years, and at the 4th year, an olive grove, very common in the Mediterranean basin, as control. Here you can see the results. So the A, the first one graph, is referred to the agricultural experimental farm of the university. And in 2015, the number of the seeds in for square meter are more or less around 9,000. And in the presence of global artichoke, this values is halved, so around 5,000 seeds for square meter. And in the presence of cultivated cardon, it's recorded a very reduction. The same trend is possible to 2017, even that the values are lower. In the other area, in Passetti 1, the trend is more or less the same. So for the control, the number of the seed for a square meter is more than 5,000. And in the presence of cultivated cardon and wild cardon, this value is notably reduced. For the other approach, the molecular one, to understand if this kind of allelopathic compounds can affect the soil microflora, the DNA was extracted directly from the soil, and PCR of 16 genes was performed using the universal primer with GC clamp for DGG. DGG, as I said before, is an electrophoretic technique and in gradient made of urea and formamide. And the gel were run overnight at 60 degrees and followed 2 hours of coloration with cyber green. Here you can see the results. In these specific techniques, in DGG, each band corresponds to a specific microorganism, so it's possible to cut the band, recover from the gel, and by sequencing the DNA, identify the microorganism. As you can see in the control, there is a band, the number one, that become very faint in the presence of globe artichoke, in the soil rhizosphere, in the presence of globe artichoke, and disappear completely in the cultivated cardon. At the same time, two different bands appear in the cultivated cardon samples, and they are very strong. So, after sequencing, these bands were cutted and analyzed by sequencing, and were identified as Bacillus subtilis, the first one, and the other two as Pseudomonas putida and Azospirillum brasiliensis. So the only bacterium affected by the presence of the allelochemical compound was the gram-positive bacterium Bacillus subtilis. At the same time, to understand if this kind of allelochemical compound can affect this different microorganism involved in the nitrogen cycle, we tested this compound, but not only the aqueous extract, only the methanolic and ethanolic extract of Cynara cardunculus, against Rhizobium leguminosarum, Sinorhizobium, and Bacillus licheniformis. The results are shown here. So any inhibition zone was recorded for Rhizobium leguminosarum and Sinorhizobium meliloti. The only bacterium that was affected by the presence of the extract was the Bacillus licheniformis, according with the GGA results. So the only gram-positive bacterium belonging to the Bacillus genus. And with the extract with methanolic and ethanolic one. Here is the last slide. You can see very clearly the inhibition halo, so the Bacillus licheniformis is not able to grow very close to the extract put here in the hole in the middle of the petri dishes, and it's very clear the halo of an inhibition. So, concluding, the effect of Cynara cardunculus extract varies with the botanical variety, with the weed species and the concentration of the extract. And the rate of germination decreased with increasing the extract concentration. The best result we have obtained using the cultivated cardoon 80%. And the most sensitive weed species were Amaranthus retroflexus, Diplotaxis erucoides, and Portulaca oleacea. For the test, the experiments on weed soil seed bank, the presence of globe artichoke cultivated and wild cardoon for the three consecutive years reduced in a significant way the amount of weed seeds in the soil seed bank in Passitti area and the other one. In addition, the cultivated cardoon decreased the number of weed species compared to the globe artichoke and the biennial rotation with fababin as used as a control. The last results regard the molecular analysis and the antibacterial activity in vitro. So the GGE showed the cultivated cardoon had only the negative influence toward the gram-positive Bacterium subtilis and any negative influence but a positive effect toward the Pseudomonas putida and Zospirillum brasiliensis. And the results of antibacterial activity are in according with the GGE results. In fact, the extract didn't exert any negative effect on the Rhizobium leguminosarum and Sinorhizobium eliloti, but only affected the gram-positive Bacterium licheniformis. So, on the basis of our results, we can conclude that it's possible to introduce Cynara cardunculus in a crop protection system in Mediterranean agrosystem to reduce the weed soil seed bank pressure without using herbicide, synthetic herbicides, and in total respect of soil bacterial community. Many thanks for your attention.